Hello, Dissenters! My name is Etalyx, and I am here today to show you and tell you about a game called Path of Exile for the PC. This is a game currently in development by Grinding Gear Games out of New Zealand. And like I said, it's currently in development, which means it's currently in closed beta right now. So not everyone will be able to play before it goes into open beta. And it should go into open beta hopefully in early 2012, and it will be releasing in 2012 as well. Now to sign up for the closed beta, for your chance to get in and play for yourself, all you have to do is visit the website and the link below in the description of this video. Once you're there, there's a clear sign up for the beta button that you should be able to click and create an account with the website. That'll sign you up. So hopefully you can get in and play it for yourself if you're interested in what you see here. And I don't really see how you can't be unless you don't like action RPGs, because that is what this is, in the vein of Diablo and Titan Quest and just all sorts of other top-down action RPGs that I probably have not played. That is the type of game that this is. As you can see, there are a variety of classes to pick from, about 5 in the beta right now. There are going to be 6 when the game releases. You got your standard fare, you know, the warrior-esque classes. I'm playing a duelist, which is a strength-dexterity hybrid. What that allows me to do is basically do my, you know, evasion and critical strike, as well as just having some nice brute strength to kill some fools. I like dual wielding. That's where I get my fun. And there is a lot of loot to find in this game. A lot of loot. Do not let that be understated in any way, shape, or form. There are so many variations of every single item. You're gonna find something. If you love loot, this is a good game to kind of, you know, quell your thirst for the chest-opening, boss-killing loot. Looting. That didn't come out right. We're just gonna pretend like I didn't say that. Anyways, moving on. So as you can see, you basically move it around from a fixed 3D perspective, beating up a lot of people hack and slash style. Now you do have some skills to spice things up. It's not just a standard click 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 with the left click. You don't have to do that. You do have a variety of skills that you can play with as well, and I'll try to show you those here in a bit. What you do is you don't rank when you level up. Let me try to phrase this appropriately. When you level up, you do not learn abilities by leveling up. You actually find abilities in the game world. Maybe they're a quest reward, maybe you find them on the ground, and by equipping those to your items, these little gems, you gain abilities to use. Like in one instance, I have a slashing ability that hits people in like an area of effect. So I've got that, and I've got a few more other skills. I haven't found that many yet because I'm still a pretty low-level character, which reminds me, the level cap is currently set to 100, so there's going to be a long ways to go before you hit that cap, and supposedly the in-game content is going to be really tough, so you're going to have to be pretty prepared in order to take that on. Now, the juicy bits, the juicy details of the game that you want to know. You want to know these details, I promise you. These are the most important bits that you're going to hear in this video. Okay, prepare yourself. You might want to sit down for this. This game is going to be completely 100% free when it releases. Yes, let that just sink in for just a second. This game is going to be free. You do not have to pay a dime in order to play it when it releases in 2012. They will have a transaction store where you can pay for, I believe, vanity items. I'm not sure what's all going to be included in that store, but according to the website, you're going to be able to buy things that change the way your character looks. If you saw on the character select screen at the beginning, all the characters, I mean, they are different. Those 5 characters are unique from each other, but you can't change their appearance. You can't change the way that they look currently. Now, why is that important? Why do you care if you can change the way your character looks? Well, this game is an online game. It is a persistent online world. You can actually play with your friends, party up with random people online if you so choose. You don't have to play with your friends. And you can make parties, go out into the world, kill things. Basically, the way that it works is there are there are cities where all the players can meet and socialize. I mean, there's also various forms of chatting in the game throughout. Like, no matter where you are in the game, you can always chat. However, in this, like, what you're looking at right now is an instance. It's a place where there aren't any other players unless someone came in with a party for me, so that everyone has, like, their own areas that they can go in and fight, and the instances will reset after a set amount of time, I do believe. Now, like I said, it's just awesome that there is a free, persistent online game that supports supposedly up to hundreds of thousands of people potentially, and that you can just do all this, run around, play with your friends, play with anybody. I am pretty excited about that. I am not even gonna lie, because I don't play many of these types of games. I think the last game that I played that was even remotely like this was Titan Quest, and I haven't played anything since Titan Quest, so I was excited to jump back in and play something action RPG hack and slash loot dropping awesomeness. So, I encourage you to research some more on this game, check it out for yourself, see if it's something you might like, and I encourage you to sign up for the closed beta. Now, what I am doing right here, I just picked up a nice new sword, one that is much better than what I currently have equipped, but I cannot use it. I don't meet the requirements right now. I don't think I'm the appropriate level or something like that. But what I'm showing you here is the skill system. There are these little gems that you pick up. I don't know if I mentioned this already. I am kind of absent-minded. But anyways, these gems dictate your skills. They're the ones that give you the abilities to slash things and do whatever. And you can actually move them around to any piece of gear that you want. It's really a great system, so if you don't want to ever lose those abilities, you can keep them, and as long as you're using them and have them equipped, they'll level up with you and actually become more powerful. It's a really cool change of pace from just leveling up, oh, you've hit level 10, here is this skill. And instead, you get to find these abilities, which any class can use. So any class can use any abilities. Whichever ones you use are the ones that are going to get more powerful and more effective the more that you play. It's a great system. What else can I tell you guys about? There is so much exciting about this game. There's going to be an entire PvP system. It's going to include arenas, rankings, ladders, item rewards, the whole nine yards. There's going to be a lot of support for PvP from what I understand. So if you love to fight other people, there is going to be lots of things made in the game just for you. Now what I'm showing you here is the skill tree. I'm not trying to show you anything, you know, really specific. Just the fact that there are a ton of skills. Oh my gosh, look at how many skills there are. I don't even understand why there's so many skills. Now, not all of these skills are unique. In fact, most of them are not. They just impact your stats in some form or another. These are all passive abilities. These are not active skills. So let that sink in for a second. See how many there are. And I think they're all unique for each individual class, specific to each class. Anyways, that's all I can think of for now. This was not supposed to be comprehensive, but I hope I told you more about this game than you already know, especially if you had not heard of it before. Hope you take an interest in it and check it out for yourself. Thank you for watching. I appreciate all of your support, and I hope to see you again. My name is Etalyx, and I will see you next time.